So we're just going to make this this short film on how I prepare a herring or a mackerel or a bluey, really any fish type of bait. The first thing I do is make a cut there at the back of its head, take its head off. Keep the head, a lot of blood inside the head, especially when you're fishing for hake or for conger. It's a great bait to use. And then I'll literally fillet the fish. So in, good sharp knife, not like this one, and then off. Set that aside. You do exactly the same with this side. You can see that the fish is split there. So now you've got your fillet. And you put that into three, really. So your first one wants to be there. Still a little bit frozen is this fish. First one there. Second. That's the row. Always keep this. It's nice to bind in with. So you've got three separate finger-sized baits. And then, especially off this mark, I'm not using too big a bait, size of your small finger. And just cut straight through them. Like that. So there's your six baits. But what I would generally do, this would be one bait here. Then I would get this bit and I would lie it on top of that. And then bind it up. I can bind it up to show you now. Hold the bait like that in the palm of your hand. And then just start to wrap. And just clench the bait together as you wrap. Makes a little bit more of a presentable bait. There's always a lot of discussions on if you should have skin out or flesh out and skin inside, or I've never noticed any difference. But it's whatever your personal preference is. Take your scissors. I'm a bit anal with this, I like to trim off all this stuff that's going to disturb my cast. And then that's it. Slip the hook through, a little bit more wrap on. Well, that's your bait. It's an average bait size for here. Catch cod, haddock, hake, whiting, dogfish, halibut, no problem. Sit that on a 3-0, 4-0 hook even. You can make bigger baits as well. You don't have to necessarily cut them in half. You can make just cut it straight down. And then that's one bit. I usually take the cage out. If you take the cage out, if you take the rib cage out, it just saves pulling it all off when you come to strip your bait off when you're rebaiting again. There. That's it. You can cut it in half or you could make it a bit thinner. If you want to make something thin and long, castable, then that's perfect. I like to do a mackerel exactly the same way, and do a herring and mackerel mix. I'm not sure it makes a lot of difference really. This bit I like to use. If I'm cod fishing, this is a great bit. You've got the liver, you've got the eggs, you've got a lot of blood and guts, a lot of scent in there, twinned with the oil from the fish. So I would just bang that all on and cast that out as a big sized bait. I wouldn't bother chopping that up. But out of one herring, you've probably got 6 casts out of one herring. Great bait to use. And the head. That's it. That's just how I would prepare a fish bait.